Back today with the QIDI Tech Q1 Pro, another 3D printer. This one's kind of interesting. It reminded me of my X1 Carbon from Bamboo, except the price point is way lower, like a fraction. Once it showed up, I could tell why the price was considerably lower, at least for some of the parts. Let me go ahead and show it to you. So here we are with the printer. It's a slightly different build volume than the X1C from Bamboo, if you are familiar with that size. You do have your spool holder that can only go on the one side. To me, that's kind of not the greatest thing. Like, I would have liked to have had the option for either side. You can only have it over here on the left. It's going to limit where you can place this if you're running like a print farm or something. It is a pretty flimsy plastic. It does move a lot. You're probably going to want to figure something better out here right out of the gate. This will be good for initial printing, but I would try to find a file and print something better, or just figure out something better. Maybe they sell something. I'm not entirely sure. You just got the power switch, the power cable on the back. That's about it. The fan exhausts and stuff. You do have a removable lid, but it is just plastic. So is the front door. It is somewhat flimsy plastic. Let me switch hands here. It's not always the easiest thing to get a hold of either. But, you know, you're saving a ton of money and they're cutting the corners by giving you plastic. It's going to work. It seals fine. It does have magnets in it that seal on the screws. So you get a nice little thing or a nice little seal there. There you go. And it grabs. And yeah, that's about that. I have printed a little with this thing, and we're going to print some more today. I did the initial setup. When you set it up, let me turn it on, because it does have its own lighting. Turn it on and wait a minute here, and I'll tell you a little bit about the machine itself. It does 245 by 245 by 240 millimeters on the build plate there. The max active chamber heating is 60 Celsius, and it says it can print right out of the box, and it's pretty much correct. All I did was I came in here, I turned it on for the first time and asked you to set your language and a couple other things. And then I just came into settings. I went to auto bed leveling. Went ahead and started that. It did its thing. It took, I don't know, 15 minutes or something. And when that was done, I did go ahead and update it. So I just came into settings again, check for updates. It had an update. I went ahead and did it over the Wi-Fi after I had set the Wi-Fi up. So you just go into network. I'm not going to show you that because my IP address and stuff is in there when it first pops up, but that's pretty much it. Since I did update it, I am going to go ahead and have it do the calibration again. So we'll do the auto bed leveling, and then it wants to preheat the bed before you start. So I will say this screen is not the most responsive. I do still have the screen cover on it though. So let's take that out. Well, we're just going to let it do that. It wasn't at the temperature that it wanted. You can see the reflection of me. So I'm going to leave this open so you don't see my lovely love handles. Let's talk about it more real quick. So while this is doing the recalibration, the auto bed leveling and everything, while this is going through this process and heating up the nozzle and all that stuff and acquiring the compensation values, let me just show you a couple of quick things. When it first comes, this bed's obviously all the way down. There's a screw there, screw there, screw there, screw there. You remove. The head was zip tied with some cardboard. You remove that. There's two other zip ties that I had to remove. And then I think there may have been some foam or something in there. And you just pulled that out, and that was it. It was ready to go. I went ahead and did the calibration. I did the update, and yeah, did a nice little test print. So once this is done, we'll come back and we'll go ahead and go through everything. I will say it does have a camera. It's hard to see. I can't get the camera in here, but there's a camera right here. It was showing me a decent preview. It was showing me the frames per second, and it was like 1 to 3. I don't know if that's different when you're like using it. I don't know how well you can capture video or anything, but it is what it is. It's nice to have it so you can at least kind of check on your print. I do feel like the head wiper here is not going to be long for the world. It moves a lot while the head's on it. Right below it here is the poop basket. Since you're not using multicolors, it's plenty large. You'll need to empty it probably once every like 20 or 30 projects, unless it's something where it decides it needs to, you know, wipe the nozzle a lot during. But other than that, yeah, this thing is, I mean, the whole housing is plastic. I showed you the windows and the door, plastic. It does print well, and we're gonna show you that. I actually just noticed something here. Let me see if I can show you better from having the door open. It's gonna be hard because it's clear plastic. So some of these are like melted or broke, and then some of them aren't. And it just kind of came like that from the factory. It literally does not impact anything at all. That's not a structural thing. That's not touching anything. Just might annoy some people. Like, I couldn't care less. If it saved me some money, then, you know, cool. This is probably gonna end up going in the garage, and this will be my like ABS printer. I do have printers inside that'll do ABS, but it's just gonna be easier to manage the fumes from ABS out there. So this will do PAHT carbon fiber, PET carbon fiber, PA12 carbon fiber, ABS GF25, PC or ABS FR. You know, it'll do a bunch of stuff. It'll do PLA too. If you want to do PLA, just remember to at least keep the door open or the lid off. You may need to do both. You don't want the PLA to get too hot and get gooey, and then you get blob of death and stuff. It does have independent motors for the bed raising. That's how it's going to do its leveling. It's starting to be pretty standard for things like this. It auto measures the Z offset. You know, it's clipper 64-bit. That camera is supposed to be 1080p. They claim 10 minutes outside of the box to get it up and running, and I would agree with that. Probably less if you don't want to do an update, but 10 for sure if you're going to do this. Maybe a hair over 10 if you're going to do this at first, which obviously you should. You probably could have printed right out of the gate, but it doesn't hurt to just let it go ahead and do this and calculate the values and stuff. I think it's about done now. Yep, there we go, we're completed. And I'm also noticing there's a bunch of schmoo around here that's kind of just like pressed into the sticker. And, you know, you're saving a lot of money, so you gotta allow for some things like that. So we've done all of that. It also comes with a few built-in files here that are local. So we'll just do, I'm not sure what the difference is between their benchies. I have some Elegoo matte PLA black that I'm almost out of in here right now. I'm not sure it's enough to do a benchy, but we're gonna try. So there you go. It's claiming 18 minutes, 3.3 meters, 10 grams. Oh yeah, I should be good. Yes, I guess we hit the play button. And there it's warning us that printing with the enclosure may cause high temperatures. Since we're doing PLA, to go ahead and keep the door open and or remove the lid. So we'll confirm that warning. And there we go. I'm gonna go ahead and let this run and we'll take a look at the benchy. So we're 14 minutes here into the benchy print, and it seems to be doing all right so far. Again, don't mind me watching tank pots. It seems to be a theme with some of my videos lately. Benchy just finished, took 21 minutes. You can see the little poop basket back there. It did poop 3 times for that, so probably get quite a few prints out of that before you gotta empty it, and it just pops off. I'm gonna get the benchy off, switch the filament. Matter of fact, let's see if there's a switch filament setting here. Replace filament. Please select temperature, we need 220. Manual unload. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and get that swapped out and we'll start printing that dish. Okay, so here's something I don't like. To unload the filament, it wants me to depress the PTFE tube little holder thing, pull the tube out, manually cut it, and then it's gonna extrude it. Yeah, that's kind of weird, but I guess that's what I gotta do. Here's something else I don't really like. For load, unload, it just does it in the corner of the plate. When I first turned it on, it just did it at a random spot back there. So I think it's just wherever the head last was, is just where it loads or unloads the filament. So yeah, just something kind of annoying, but again, you're saving a ton of money on this thing because it doesn't have these bells and whistles like a cutter and, you know, metal and everything. So, you know, keep that in mind. I'm very happy with the benchy. We'll take a look at that after this is done and we'll take a look at them together. But overall, I'm very happy with this. So it just finished a few seconds ago. Took 2 hours and 11 minutes. I'm gonna let the bed cool for a second, but I am very happy with that. This definitely seems like a great printer. You do sacrifice some things at the price point. You know, the door's kind of flimsy plastic, the lid's kind of flimsy plastic. You don't have the cutter that's built in, so you gotta cut stuff, you know. But other than that, like, I like this thing a lot. All I did was just grabbed this STL. I ran it through Orca for the Q1 Pro, put it on USB drive, put it on here, and it's looking great. Let me get this off the build plate and let's take a look at it. But first, we'll go ahead and take a look at this Benchy. The Benchy came out wonderful. I didn't even dry this filament. It had been sitting out for a few days, and there's no stringing at all. There is a little bit of weirdness there on the corner of the boathouse or the pilot house. But other than that, like, oh, there's a little bit of stringing right there. It's hard to see, I know. I'm very happy with that. Nice and smooth on the sides. One side's a little smoother than the other, but it comes out pretty nice. So let me go ahead and get this out of here. See if I can do it without taking the plate out. Nope, I'm gonna have to flex the plate. Wow, that magnet is strong. That is the strongest magnet I've felt on a build plate. Okay, there we go. See how easy this is to line back up. I will note that I did not wash this plate at all once it came. So I did not put any glue down. I just wanted to see exactly what it would be like. And this textured plate is different than other like textured PIA plates I found. It feels more like a whetstone for sharpening knives. Let's get this back up in here so you see it. I am extremely happy with that. Let's take a look at this on the table here. Everything looks wonderful. That is gorgeous. I really like this filament. This is some filament I actually found on Temu, I think. And it's just a rose red and sky blue. That came out wonderful on this. I guess this could be like a key tray or coin tray or something. I thought it would be a good test for this. I had 2 hours, 11 minutes, you know, not bad. I just used the default settings that Orca kind of just populated with. Did not change anything at all, and it came out great. So I have run some ABS through the QIDI now. It's been a week. I did play with it a little. You can see here it kind of needs cleaned up a little. That's not the print's fault. That's just, you know, stuff that peels off. I've done it on the rest of the letter opener. But it does do ABS pretty well. This is the first time I've ever printed ABS and everything looks fine. You know, the top layer had a couple of little issues, but not that big of a deal. I didn't run through settings for the filament or anything. I just used the default that was in Orca for ABS, and this was my first attempt, and I'm extremely satisfied. I did use the chamber heater to heat it up and stuff, but yeah, that wraps it up for this video.